The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1906. Highlight the entire row if the date is over 60 days old. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in by Ross from California. I have a date, say, June 11, 2014, and I need to highlight the row when it gets to 60 days past this date. How can I do that? Boy, if it wasn't for the row, this would be relatively easy. But first, let's talk about a great little function called equal today. I bet you thought I was going to say now. Everyone seems to know now, which gives you the date and the time. Today, though, just gives you the date. It doesn't give you the time portion of that. And that function is a great function because it will recalculate. I'm recording this on August 11th, but if I came in and opened this workbook tomorrow, that date would be August 12th. So the today function, no arguments there. Let's first just say if we wanted to highlight the date in column C, if it's more than 60 days past that date, we would select all the data, so Control Shift down arrow, and then here under conditional formatting, we want to highlight cells that are less than, because we're looking for things that are more than 60 days old, so less than a certain date, and that date is going to be equal today minus 60. All right, so now we just have the things that are older than June 11th are being highlighted, and right now they do it in light red fill with dark red text. You can open this dropdown and choose any of the various colors, or you can go to custom format, and we'll take a look at that when we have to highlight the whole row. But for right now, you can see how easy that would be if you just had to highlight the one cell. But if we want to highlight the whole row, all right, so that's a little bit more difficult. We have to figure out which row is the first row in our data set. In this case, it's row 2. And which column has the dates. In this case, it's column C, and your data is probably going to be somewhere else, but we're going to select all the data from here down, so Control Shift right arrow, Control Shift down arrow, and then we're going to go to conditional formatting and new rule. See, these items they have here don't have the one powerful one, which is called use a formula to determine which cells to format. And we have to write a formula that is relevant to cell A2, but would work in any of the cells. So we're going to say equal C2, and I have to put a dollar sign carefully in there. I don't want to lock down the row 2 because I need the reference to change, but I do need to lock down the column C. So I can press the F4 key. Once we'll lock them both down, twice we'll lock down just the row. Third time, though, we'll lock down just the column. That's what I need. So if the date in C2 is less than, and I'm going to put parentheses here, today, open and close parentheses, minus 60. All right, so we take today's date, August 11th, we subtract 60 days from it, so we'll get back to roughly June 11th, and then if the date there is older than June 11th, so it's more than 60 days that's been in the database, then we want to highlight the whole row. And here, we click the format button, and we have all kinds of different things we can do. We can change the font color, we can change the fill color. Maybe we'll just highlight everything in a, kind of a some sort of a red, and then change the font color to be white or something like that. You can also change the border or even the number format. So we'll click OK and then click OK, and we'll see anything that is more than 60 days ago. The entire row is now highlighted in red, so very easy to spot those stale items that we need to make sure get taken care of or checked up on, or whatever. Now you can imagine if you have a different set of rules, like if you want to see everything that's more than 30 days old or coming up in the next 3 days, you can just change that formula. The really important thing there is to lock down the column that has the date. All right, so as you think about that, we always want to be looking, no matter which cell in this range that we're evaluating from, we're always looking back to column C, so putting that dollar sign just before the C, not before the 2, is the important part. Well, hey, I want to thank Ross for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.